Hello everyone, good evening. Welcome to NEET PG Life Daily. Myself Dr. Apurva Mittal and I am your educator for anesthesia on this prestigious platform for Unacademy. And today we'll be discussing about oxygen delivery devices. Okay friends, today we'll be discussing about the oxygen delivery devices. So welcome to Unacademy friends, and by getting the Unacademy Plus subscription, what are the advantages? You'll be able to avail all the live classes for the 19 subjects that are needed for the preparation of NEET examinations, and also you can interact with the educator. So it will be a live classroom like environment. We'll be having daily test series and analysis through which you can evaluate your progress and come to know how the questions are asked, and also live doubt clearing sessions in which you can clear the doubt pertaining to the subject from the educator. So these are the advantages of Unacademy Plus subscription. And now this Unacademy Plus subscription, you can avail it for 12 months or 24 months course. And if you apply my code, that is Apurva Live, APORVA Live, you can get 10% discount on the same. So let's start our today's topic, that is oxygen therapy devices. Friends, am I loud and clear? Okay, fine. So let's start our today's topic, that is oxygen therapy devices. Now, first question that is asked, okay, why do we actually need oxygen therapy? What are the conditions in which we need to give oxygen therapy? Not all patients require oxygen therapy, right? So who all need oxygen therapy? So it is if the patient is either in the cardiac or respiratory arrest, if the patient is not able to maintain the oxygenation, right? So cardiac and respiratory arrest, these patients need oxygen therapy. If patient has hypoxemia, if patient has hypoxemia, right? Hypoxemia, that is the PaO2 level less than 60 millimeters of mercury, or the saturation is less than 90%, then also patient requires oxygen therapy. Hypotension, that is the systolic blood pressure is less than 100 millimeters of mercury, low cardiac output states, right, and metabolic acidosis. Okay, in those cases also, and if the patient is in the respiratory distress. So these are the conditions in which patient requires oxygen therapy. Okay, so these are the conditions in which the patient requires oxygen therapy, like cardiac and respiratory arrest, hypoxemia, hypotension, low cardiac output states, and metabolic acidosis and respiratory distress. So these are the indications for oxygen therapy. Now there are certain devices, okay, which give the oxygen to the patient, through which we can give the oxygen therapy to the patient. Okay, and these oxygen delivery devices, depending upon the ambient pressure. Okay, ambient pressure. So these are of two types, that is the variable performance. The variable performance devices are the ones in which the performance of the device is affected by the respiratory parameters of the patient. Okay, in the variable performance devices, okay, what happens, the performance, okay, or the oxygen delivery, okay, it depends upon the respiratory parameters of the patient, that is the respiratory rate or the tidal volume, that is the variable performance devices. Then the next one, we have the fixed performance devices. These are the devices whose oxygen delivery is not affected by the patient's parameter. Oxygen delivery is not affected by the tidal volume or the respiratory rate. They will give a fixed amount of oxygen or the FiO2 to the patient. So these are the fixed performance devices, right? And other is the positive pressure ventilation. Okay, in that we have non-invasive and invasive methods that I have discussed in other class, that is in the mechanical ventilation. So today we'll be discussing about the variable performance and the fixed performance devices. Is it clear? Is it clear? Any doubts in this? Any doubts till now? So these are the oxygen delivery devices. Now, according to the flow, that was according to the performance, if it is fixed or if it is variable, according to the flow, that is flow of oxygen per minute, okay, the flow of oxygen per minute, these devices are in turn divided into the low flow and the high flow system. Okay, in the low flow and the high flow system, the example of the low flow system is the nasal prongs. Okay, and the example of the high flow system is the venturi mask. So according to how much flow of oxygen in liters per minute is supplied to the patient, it is the low flow, that is the nasal prong, and the high flow system, that is the venturi mask. Okay, so these are the examples of the oxygen delivery devices. Now, I told you what are the fixed performance. I already told you what are the fixed performance systems. What are the variable performance systems? The variable performance systems, they do not, remember, they do not provide constant FiO2, right? Because it depends upon the patient's respiratory rate and the tidal volume. Okay, as it depends upon the patient's respiratory rate and tidal volume, these are the features who do not provide the constant FiO2. Okay, and in them, the part of the tidal volume is provided by the room air. Okay, the part of the tidal volume is provided by the room air. So these are the variable performance systems. An example is the nasal cannula or the simple mask. Okay, nasal cannula or simple mask, these are the example of the variable performance system. Now, fixed performance, I told you fixed performance is what? It is independent. It is independent of the patient. So it provides a constant predetermined inspired oxygen concentration. For example, in case of the venturi mask, I'll tell you in detail how does the venturi mask works and how it is providing the fixed performance system, how it is not dependent upon the patient's respiratory rate and tidal volume. Till now, is it clear? So till now, I've discussed about the oxygen delivery devices. So revising it, so oxygen delivery devices, you have to see if it is a variable performance or a fixed performance device, and if it is a low flow system or a high flow system, right? Now, coming to the first oxygen therapy device or the delivery device, we all know this is the nasal cannula or the nasal prongs. Okay, this is the nasal cannula or the nasal prongs. Now, how we will describe an oxygen therapy device, we will first say if it is a low flow or a high flow. So the nasal cannula, it is a low flow oxygen therapy device. Okay, it is a low flow oxygen therapy device, and it is a variable performance. It has a variable perform, and it does not have any capacity. It does not have any reservoir, right? So there is no capacity. Oxygen is delivered through cannulas, but it is at the low flow rate, that is around 0.5 to 5 liter per minute. Okay, it is around 0.5 to 5 liter per minute. Is it clear? Are you getting my point? So nasal cannula, it is a low flow variable performance. It does not have any capacity, and it is at the low flow rate, that is 0.5 to 5 liter per minute. And in this, the inspired air, because it is a low flow system, the inspired air, it is diluted with that of the room air. Okay, the inspired air is diluted with the room air, and if asked the maximum FiO2 which can be given with nasal cannula, that is only 0.4, that is only 40%. The maximum FiO2 that can be provided by the nasal cannula is only 40%. Is it clear? So this is a nasal cannula, low flow, variable performance. ठीक है, एंड द इंस्पायर्ड एयर बिकॉज इट इज नॉट एबल टू मीट द इंस्पिरेटरी रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द पेशेंट, इट विल बी डायल्यूटेड विद द रूम एयर एंड इट इज वेरिएबल. ओके, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यूजिंग द नेजल कैनुला? सी, इट इज अ वेरी, इट इज पोर्टेबल, राइट? Portable, no weight device, so it is easy to use. It is comfortable to the patient. Even if the nasal cannula is applied, the patient can communicate easily. The patient can have the food easily. So it is comfortable for the patient, and it is very important. It is ideal for claustrophobic patients. So these are the advantages of the nasal cannula. But what are the disadvantages? First, it is a variable. Okay, it is a variable oxygen therapy device, therefore it is has unpredictable FiO2. Because it is variable, it has unpredictable FiO2, and it is not appropriate in respiratory distress. The FiO2 which can be provided is only 0.4, and it is not under pressure, right? So it is not appropriate in respiratory distress. If by chance we are giving high flow oxygen, okay, in cases of high flow oxygen or else non-humidified air, okay, non-humidified air, what can happen? It can cause dryness of the mucosa and the crusting of the secretions. So these are the disadvantages of the nasal cannula. Is it clear? Any doubts in this? So this is about the nasal cannula. Then the other oxygen therapy device, okay, it is the face mask. Now the face mask can be the simple face mask, the transparent face mask which we see, or the Hudson's face mask, okay, so this is the simple face mask, or it can be partial rebreather mask. I'll just show you the diagram and then you'll understand. A face mask with a reservoir bag, okay, can be a partial rebreather or a non-rebreather face mask, right? A face mask with a reservoir bag can be partial rebreather or non-rebreather mask. And the last is the Venturi mask. What is Venturi mask? What is the principle behind it? And how it is a fixed performance, that I'll just tell you in the later slides. So the face mask, it can be the simple face mask, the partial rebreather, non-rebreather, and the Venturi mask. So all of you must have seen this mask. This is a simple face mask, right? Simple face mask. Then how we will describe it? It is a low flow, variable performance, and it has a capacity. So it is a small capacity oxygen therapy device, right? In the nasal cannula, there was no capacity. It has a capacity. Okay, it has a small capacity, low flow, variable performance device. And how is the oxygen delivered? It is delivered through a small bore tube connected to the base of. So it is a small bore tube which is connected to the base of the oxygen mask. So that is how the oxygen is supplied to it. Now, how it is having a small capacity? Because the oxygen gets collected in the apparatus dead space, okay, at the end of expiration, and it can be inhaled at the beginning of next breath, okay. So it has a small capacity, and the oxygen, it gets collected in the apparatus dead space at the end of expiration, and it is inhaled at the beginning of the next breath. And remember, nasal cannula was able to provide only 0.4 FiO2, but this face mask, okay, face mask can provide 35 to 60% FiO2, and the flow rate should be from 5 to 10 liter per minute. If it is less than 5 liter per minute, there are high chances of rebreathing. Okay, there are high chances of free breathing, because if the flow rate is less, there more amount of carbon dioxide will be rebreathed, okay, to meet the oxygen demand. So this is about the simple face mask or the Hudson's face mask. Is it clear? Any doubts in this? Any doubts in this? So this is the oxygen face mask. Now, what are the advantages of this mask? What are the advantages? It is quick and easy setup, right? It is quick and easy setup and apply. But what are the disadvantages? It is uncomfortable, especially for the claustrophobic patients. It is not ideal for the claustrophobic patients, and it is uncomfortable while the patient is talking or eating. And it is has a variable performance, so it has an unpredictable FiO2. It has an unpredictable FiO2, and not more than 0.5 FiO2 can be delivered through the face mask. Not more than 0.5 FiO2 can be delivered through the face mask. And remember, carbon dioxide rebreathing can occur if the flow rate is very less. That is less than 2 liters per minute, or the minute ventilation is very high. So we have to take care of all these things. We cannot keep the flow rate of the oxygen too low. The FiO2 maximum can be given is only 0.5. In nasal cannula, we saw that it is 0.4. And it is not comfortable to the patient while the patient is eating or talking. Is it clear? Is it clear? So that was a simple face mask, which is a transparent face mask. Now, there is a face mask with a reservoir bag. Okay, there is a face mask with a reservoir bag. So reservoir face mask. Okay, remember, it is a high oxygen, low flow. Okay, high oxygen, low flow, and variable performance device. Remember, high oxygen, low flow, variable performance, and it provides, remember, higher FiO2. It in fact, the highest FiO2 is by this, so provides a higher FiO2, as the reservoir bag is attached to the face mask, and it is of two types: partial rebreathing and non-rebreathing. So we will see the partial non-rebreathing face mask. So this is the face mask with the reservoir bag. So remember, it is also a variable low flow but high oxygen low flow variable. Okay, oxygen delivery devices. Now it has a face mask with a reservoir bag. With a reservoir bag, and there is a vent which is here, and there is expiration. The expired gases are exhaled through it, and therefore there is no rebreathing. There is no rebreathing, and therefore it is non-rebreather mask. It is a non-rebreather mask. It does not permit mixing of exhaled gases with the fresh gas supply. Okay, the one-way valve, it ensures a fresh gas supply with minimum dilution from the entrainment of the room air. So one-way valve is the one which ensures that there is fresh oxygen supply, and it does not permit the mixing of the exhaled gases with the fresh gas supply. And remember, this was the question which was asked, which one provides the maximum oxygen concentration. So it is the face mask with the reservoir. It provides the maximum highest concentration of oxygen, that is around 95 to 100% at the flow rate of 6 to 15 liter per minute. Okay, advantages, yes, fast and easy setup, but disadvantages are FiO2 is variable. Okay, if there is air entrapment due to the poor mask fit and the reservoir bag, remember, it must always be inflated. If it is completely deflated, that means the oxygen flow rates are low, and we should increase the oxygen flow rate. Is it clear? Any doubts in this? So this is a face mask with a reservoir bag which is a non-rebreather. Remember yahan pe agar vent hai, if there is a vent over here, that means it is a non-rebreather mask. Iske through the gases will be exhaled out, okay, and therefore there won't be any mixing of the exhaled gases with the fresh gas supply. Any doubts here? Any doubts? Any doubts till now? The oxygen therapy devices are important. Okay, so this is a non-rebreather mask, and remember it is the one which provides the highest concentration of oxygen. It is the one which provides highest concentration of oxygen, that is 95% to 100% at a flow rate of 6 to 15 liters per minute. Now coming to the Venturi mask. Okay, so I told you it is also a high flow, it is fixed performance. Remember, Venturi mask is a fixed performance mask, okay, and it is based on the Venturi effect. So this is the face mask, and if this, okay, any of these have been attached in between, then it is a Venturi mask. So Venturi mask is a high flow fixed performance, and it has a Venturi effect. Now what is Venturi effect? Venturi effect, it is based on Bernoulli's principle. Remember, it is based on the Bernoulli's principle. Imagine this is a tube, okay, which has a constriction in between. Now there is the flow of the fluid. So when this fluid flows through a constriction, okay, when this fluid flows through the constriction, the velocity must increase to satisfy the equation of continuity. Whenever there is constriction, the velocity of the flow should increase to satisfy the equation of equity. And principle of conservation of energy is there. Any gain in kinetic energy due to increase in fluid velocity must be balanced by a drop in pressure distilled to the constriction. So whenever there is constriction, the flow, the velocity will increase, but the pressure distilled to the constriction will decrease, and that is Bernoulli's principle. Is it clear? So Venturi mask, see, there is a constriction, right? So whenever there is the flow of the air through this constriction, the velocity will be increased and the pressure will drop. And as there is negative pressure, it will entrap the air from the outside. Dr. Poonam, hello, welcome to the class. Any doubts till here? So I was telling the Venturi device or the Venturi mask. Okay, so what is here? See, this is a Venturi, okay, Venturi principle over here. What will happen? I told you, whenever there is constriction, so what will happen? The velocity will increase, okay, but the pressure will decrease. So here at this point the pressure will decrease, and because there is decrease in the pressure, through these holes, there will be entrapment of air from the outside, okay, and that is how the Venturi principle works. Now this entrapment of air depends upon the Venturi, okay, Venturi ka yahan pe kitna constriction hai, the air around it, and there are different color coded Venturi devices. So the Venturi mask, okay, there is air entrapment mask, jet orifice, okay, oxygen is supplied to the mass through a narrow, okay? So oxygen is supplied through a narrow bore tube through this venturi, okay? And that is under pressure. Okay, now this oxygen under pressure is forced through small jet orifice which is entering the mask, and because there is constriction there is negative pressure and the room air is entrained into the mask through the apertures of the venturi barrel so this is how the venturi mask or the venturi effect, which is based on the Bernoulli's principle, work. Is it clear? Is it clear, Dr. Poonam, Dr. Piyush? Is it clear? Any doubts in this? So this is the venturi mask. Okay. So color coding. So maximum FiO2 which can be there, that is 0.6 at 15 liters of oxygen. So we have seen maximum FiO2 till now, it was by the face mask with a reservoir bag, which is a non-breathable mask. Okay, non-breathable mask. Now, coming to the last oxygen therapy device, these are the manual resuscitators. Okay, there are different manual resuscitators which can be used as an oxygen therapy devices. What are the manual resuscitators? These are portable. These are portable manual ventilating devices. Okay, portable manual ventilating devices which are used during the resuscitation of the patient. Okay, so resuscitation of the patient or during transport of the patient or as a standby in a non-functioning anesthesia machine. The most commonly used manual resuscitator is a ambu bag. Okay, the most commonly used manual resuscitator device is a ambu bag. Okay, you all must have seen this ambu bag. So when we are using, see, ambu bag, it is portable. And remember, whenever you are transporting a patient or in a OT, in spite of the fact that your anesthesia machine is working properly, the oxygen supply is proper, you should always have a ambu bag at the standby. Okay, so standby during the transport, during the resuscitation of the patient, manual resuscitators can be used. So this is what is an ambu bag. And what is ambu bag? It is actually artificial manual breathing unit. Okay, it is artificial manual breathing unit. So this is a ambu bag with a face mask. And the reservoir bag, the quantity of it in an adult is around 1200 ml, in the pediatric age group it is 500, and in the neonatal it is 250 ml. So this is what is the ambu bag, and remember, ambu bag, it is a artificial manual breathing unit. Okay, it will provide 21% of the oxygen. Okay, so this is artificial manual breathing unit. Any doubts? So friends, this was all for today's class. This was all about the oxygen therapy devices. And please remember the fixed performance, the variable performance, the low flow and the high flow devices. And questions are asked about, the question has been asked, which of the following provides the maximum concentration of oxygen? So that was a face mask with a non-rebreathing face mask with a reservoir. So, and on the ambu bag also, what is ambu bag, what it is, a manual resuscitator, what are the advantages of ambu bag, all these things have been asked. And see, here is a opening, here is a port, and if we attach a oxygen delivery port or a oxygen tube through it, we can give 100% FiO2 through ambu bag also. So these are the advantages of the ambu bag. Okay, so that was all for today's class. And on the Telegram app, you all know there is a channel, that is lifedaily.me or Meet PG channel. On this channel, we are daily posting Okay, when will be the classes held and at what time will be the class? So tomorrow same time at 7:30 p.m. Okay, we will be having the ACLS latest guidelines. Okay, latest 2020 guidelines class. What are the changes which have been made in ACLS latest 2020 guidelines? So this will be the class for tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. on the YouTube channel. Okay, and I told you by getting the Unacademy Plus subscription, these are the advantages, like you'll be having daily live classes. Also, you can interact with the educator. So it is like you are, in a live classroom-like environment you will get. And also you can clear the doubts at that time itself through the Plus subscription. And please, for the Plus subscription, you have to install the Unacademy Learning app. Select the NEET PG. Get the Plus subscription, which you can get for either 12 months or 24 months. Okay, for 1 year or 2 year through this, you'll be having daily live classes, you'll be having mock tests. So if you take it for 1 or 2 years, it will be really advantageous for you. And please apply the code, that is Apoorva Live, APOORVA Live. You can get 10% discount on the same. And on the YouTube, we have a channel, Unacademy NEET PG. Please subscribe to it, click the bell icon, like and share. And if you use my code, that is Apoorva Life, APOORVA Life, you can get 10% discount on the same. So that was all for today's class. Thank you and have a nice day. If any doubts, please let me know. Okay, if any doubts, Dr. Poonam, Dr. Piyush, any doubts in this? Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.